Fire the cannons, it's time to get this W. What you gonna do when the Bucks running over you? Tampa, Tampa. They yelling Tampa, Tampa. You fear the crew, we don't do it like these others. Black and red, remember those colors. Tampa, yeah, yeah. They yelling Tampa, support your ski, check it.
What supplements have you seen that these guys are taking that are allowed? Are they taking protein shakes? Are they taking weight gainers, protein bars, creatine, beta alanine, things like that? What are they taking, man?
I'd say probably the most popular supplement, if you will, is the protein powder.
Okay.
You know, there's probably not a guy on the team that's not taking a protein powder. There may be some, but and some of the basics, you know, multivitamins, fish oils seem to be pretty popular.
Yeah. Creatine?
Some.
Really?
Some, yeah.
I'm surprised.
I would say maybe about 20% of our guys. And then the other would be an HMB. HMB is pretty popular, yeah.
It's expensive.
It is. And it's a constituent of leucine, and it helps drive the start to protein synthesis and recovery. Yeah. And so a lot of guys will take that before and after a workout, and then also before and after a game to help with their recovery process.
Yeah, that's very, very smart.
During the season. But
what is your take on these guys using protein powder instead of food? What is your opinion on this?
I'm really a food first and then supplement whatever we need to supplement. That's what I really, really push guys on, because I think that there's a lot of guys that look towards the supplement to replace the food, whole food.
For convenience, laziness,
exactly,
sometimes, a lot of different
reasons. And sometimes they just don't know. And so that's what I'm there to do, is educate them. If they don't know how to cook, I want to teach them how to cook. Or if they don't know how to grocery shop, I'm going to teach them how to shop.
You teach them how to cook?
I have, actually. I'm not much of a cook myself, but in terms of, you know, cooking rice or pasta, just the little things.
Yeah.
They have no clue.
Wow. And, well, they play football. They're football players.
Yeah, you know, but you got to teach them the basics sometimes, even if it is, you know, using a microwave. But that's just comes with the territory of the job. So whole foods, and then supplement whatever we need to supplement. That's the approach that I take.
Now, what do you have? You talked about recovery. You're a huge proponent of recovering. You know, if you're not recovered, you're not going to play. And it's true, man. That recovery, that's what in the Gatorade commercials, what do they call that? Help me out, guys. Fifth quarter, right? They call that
fifth quarter, right?
What do you have your players taking post-workout?
Post-workout, we really get a combination of more of a simpler carbohydrate, in other words, a sugar.
Okay, like what?
Because
what kind of?
The product we do use a lot of Gatorade products. We use the Recover Gatorade cans. There are also ones that come in these little orange cap bottles.
Yeah, I've
and they
those.
Usually have about 45 to 55 grams of carbohydrate in the form of a simpler sugar and about 20 to 25 grams of protein. Not a lot of protein, more really trying to focus on spiking insulin and getting the carbohydrate into the muscle, as well as kind of slip the protein in into the muscle cell to really drive that protein synthesis. Chocolate milk is a favorite. That's actually one of the things that I'm so glad that I sort of brought to the table, so to speak, when I first came here, is the benefits of chocolate milk. And a lot of studies are showing that chocolate milk is just as effective as some of the protein powders or the post-workout supplements, and in combination can actually be a five-fold increase in the benefit. Some other studies have shown that the benefit of soy protein with a casein protein with a whey protein can actually sort of cover all ends in the
soy recovery.
And I know there's a lot of
hate
towards soy, but you know, in terms of estrogen production and increase of estrogen levels, but not to a significant level.
Yeah, so you would have to eat so much dang soy.
Yes.
I mean, you'd have to be wolfing down soy milk, soy products, edamame, or what is that?
Edamame?
Yeah, edamame.
It's basically soybeans.
Yeah, soybeans. I mean, you'd have to be popping those things like Tic Tacs.
Yeah.
Now listen, guys, listen. Did you hear what this man said? He's the team freaking dietitian for the Buccaneers, brah. Listen, I've been telling y'all, eat a simple carbohydrate carbohydrate because he wants an insulin spike to help shuttle that into the muscles. So we're talking about an insulin spike and we're talking about protein, and he's talking about a Gatorade supplement right after a workout. Mm-hmm. Same, this ain't me just talking to you about it, all right? This is not Jay Cutler, this is not Phil Heath, this is my bra, all right? Kevin from the Buccaneers, awesome. Let me ask you a quick question, this is the last question, all right? This is more towards you, all right? I'm gonna just hit you over the head with this. This dude was absolutely shredded, and I really hope, we might be able to get some clips and show you on stage, him on stage on the video of this dude, specifically his back was like fucking just insane. Dieting for so long, how did you, bro, how did you get that shredded, man?
Like you said, it's just, I think
the tons of cardio, tons of just,
you know what,
low carb.
I'd say number one is just discipline. I mean, really, it's just saying no to your friends. Yeah. I mean, really, I mean, I could go out to a restaurant with my buddies and be totally fun and have my food with me, or have eaten it before, or have it right after, and you know, they'll pass the wing to me. I'm like, nah, man, I'm good.
Yeah, like, you gotta say no. You gotta say no to peer pressure.
I'll drink this water. The other thing is consistency.
Yeah.
You gotta be consistent in anything that you do. But if I were to go, you know, off the wall and just have, you know, a bunch of Burger King, McDonald's, or, you know, I wouldn't feel good about myself. And I refused to embarrass myself on stage. That was number one. It was my first competition, and that was another thing. I was like, I'm not gonna be embarrassed. I think the other thing too is patience. I cut for 17 weeks, and there's a reason for that. That wasn't an accident. It could have, you know, it could have been 16, it could have been 18, but it was 17 weeks for a reason. And that was because when I started my cut, I was 256, and I wanted to get down to, my goal weight was 219. Mm.
Based how much off did you weigh in it?
I was actually 214 the
214?
Day.
214? Well.
But I was probably a real, you know, 218, 219, you know, with the water and whatnot, shedding the water. But I really wanted to lose 1 to 2 pounds a week because I wanted to lose fat, not muscle.
Okay, wait. All right, what did you say? Say it one more time.
I wanted to lose fat and not muscle.
Oh my gosh, he said 1.5 pounds a week.
Mm-hmm.
Now listen, most of you guys call that bro science. Let me tell you this, that is real science, homeboy. 1 to 1.5 pounds a week. You don't want to lose too much per week or you're tapping into your muscle.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Kevin, you look good, man. It was a pleasure interviewing you, being your judge. Thanks for coming on board on our YouTube channel. Guys, listen, go Bucks!
Thanks, Tim.
It's time to get this W. What you gonna do when the Bucks running over you? Tampa. They yelling Tampa. You fear the crew. We don't do it like these others. Black and red. Remember those colors. Tampa. Yeah. They yelling Tampa. Yeah.